All right, we're gonna do a spin art. I haven't done a 10 by 20. I've got some new ideas. And I'm not sure. I'm not sure exactly how this is gonna come out. I think I'm gonna do both sides. I'm gonna cover up one side and we'll just see which side comes out better. So we'll get some white on both sides. Okay. And I thinned some of these out to see if that makes a difference. Boy, that's really thin. That's really thin too. These might be all too thin. Oh boy. Well, that's a lot thinner than I anticipated. We'll just try it out. Let's see. I think I figured out how to baby my drill and keep it working for a while anyway. Okay, so that thin paint kind of just mixes, which is, you know, something. Gives us an idea. Okay, that's a lot. The thin paint was kind of an experiment. I used some airbrush reducer and acrylics, because I wanted some more translucent looking stuff, and it looks like it worked actually for that. All right, let's see. Okay, my biggest problem here, so we did not do that plan. I'm gonna put my light. Just had it all. Oh, I kind of like that. Let's see. Get that there. Let's go like this. I feel like I didn't really pick enough colors here. Oh, I know what I did. I made this color. It all washed away. So let's get some of the thick stuff. Try putting that on here. Oh, it's not wanting to come out of there. Fix it. That's way too much. Oh, there we go. That's a lot. That's getting closer. Getting closer to what we want. So, let's just do one last circle here. You know what? Let's Ooh. Hmm. Well. Well, it looks like we're getting some interesting cells. I think that's from putting it over the top of this stuff. So we may have to do some more experiments with that. It's pretty dark. I think I want to lighten it up. Most of these are black light colors. So that's going to look cool. What color should I add? How about this? This might be our color. This one's gone. Oop. I think this is it. And let's try. I don't like the glow in the dark. The glow in the dark paint sucks. I have not seen that it does much of anything as far as glowing in the dark. And it's not as bright as the regular acrylics that are neon. So maybe there are some good glow-in-the-dark paints. I just haven't found them yet. I tried a couple different ones and they all suck. This looks like it came straight out of the 80s. I think it's a good start. I like the cells. And we'll just let it dry. Perfect. Thank you. for now. Let's see here. Right there. That'll be good. A little bit shine through there. Okay. Now, what color? I'm kind of really limited on space here. It's really debating on what colors I want. So it's going to be, I think I'm going to do red. Well, no, so the moon is red, so that's not really ideal. Maybe I should do blue. All right, we'll go with blue. I'll do blue and red. So that was our deep blue. Let's get some lagoon. Some oasis blue. Kind of going to be a dark painting, so I want to make sure that it's not too dark. Keep forgetting that I need to, on the first step, before I do anything, put a black border around the edge of the painting. I didn't do it. That looks pretty. Now that's where I'm gonna cut. For the short, the first short anyway, because this won't be done today. So that looks cool. Oh, I just realized this just, oh no, it's not, okay. Yeah, okay, okay, so that looks cool. Just need to let it dry and get my details in. Pick my colors. Kind of looks like blue and purple are going to be my colors. Blue and purple is going to look good, I think. Let's see how the black light stuff dries. It's gonna get covered up. I'll save what I can. All right. This right here. shot. Make sure I have the dust. We can go. Alright. Yeah. Just put some tape on it. Okay, I'm gonna need a little piece right here. Good enough. Okay. Now, let's see what lines we want to put in. It's so dark. Kind of want to go with white on this one. I think I will do that first thing. Man, I hesitate putting so much light on it. Okay, so let's get this angle. Okay, there's one angle. I now want this angle. It's just for a reference, because I'm going to paint over that also. Now, this one's a little tricky. I don't like triangles. And that's what I'm gonna get if I do this wrong. Thank you. this angle. Okay. That doesn't look right either. Well, the first thing I can see, I can be sure, is there's no color at all in this. So, dark, light, it's going to be the plan. And let's, I'm going to go purples. The purple should have been a dark. Okay, so now we got so much going on here. I gotta wait for this to dry. It's gotta wait. Okay. Let's do the opposite on this side. Oops. get some of this. And all my caps are dying. Okay. Let me get some new ones. That's gonna be cool. Okay, so now I really have to decide. This looks pretty clean. That looks clean. This. Just don't like what I have. No matter what, I'm going to have a line there. So I need to touch that up now. And it's going to have to be white. See, now I have a line there. I'll have to get rid of it. If I move that, I'm going to stop it. I think I'm stuck with it. All right, well, let's get a new cap for that one. Just change that cap. Got some coverage now. All right. You know, I'm just gonna leave it. Okay. truth. I didn't really plan this one at all. This painting was actually, didn't take long at all. It did. Just one day. But I started early. That's not bad for no plan. Now, just hit it with some semi-gloss. Make these colors pop.